What's going on, Power Squad? Will with Will Power here. Today I want to talk about scheduling. With 5 years of experience and over 70 rehabs under my belt, it usually takes about 3 to 4 months from start to finish. This is for the 1,500 square foot average 3-2 single family home full rehab. The time frame most investors always shoot out is 6 to 8 weeks. It's never happened within that time frame, from my experience. I ain't gonna sugarcoat shit for you. It always takes 3 to 4 months. This is always a problem that I have when I'm walking to give estimates and I tell them the time frame. Everybody freaks out. I don't have time to sugarcoat it. I want to tell you how it is. I'm telling you and I'm speaking from my experience because I want you to succeed. The main delays are usually during the rough phases with permitting and city inspection. Any seasonal investor can tell you that East Point's a pain in the ass with this. Stay away from East Point unless it's a great deal and you have the resources for the delays that are going to happen due to inspections and permitting. Other delays include weather, which is rain in the summer. You can't paint and do work in the exterior. In the wintertime, that's the worst. You got cold, if you got snow, getting to the job site, delays if the roads are closed, when businesses are closed due to snow. Painting below 50 degrees, the paint doesn't dry, it starts to drip. So you gotta get heaters and make sure that the heating is working in the house so the paint dries. If not, this just causes more delays. The finished product is not good, the quality. Delays caused by materials are usually into the second or third month, caused by the finishes ordered not arriving on schedule or the materials not in stock at your supply house. Now let's talk about the delays caused by the subs. If a sub misses a day or two, for whatever reason, it's not enough to cause a major delay to the project. For the most part, subs will usually make it up by staying longer hours or working through the weekend. That's why it's always important to agree on a payment schedule for work completed, work gets paid. If the subs haven't returned within 3 days, that's abandonment of the job. I reach out to them and let them know if they're not back on site tomorrow or whatever day you guys agree upon, they will be replaced. The last thing you want to do is have another contractor, another sub, come behind another one. You want to avoid this by all means possible. Coming behind another contractor is never good for both parties, the investor and the new contractor that is coming, as well as the other contractor that got fired because he's missing out on his money. This will be a topic for another video. With this being said, when you hire Will Power, you don't hire the sub. You hire us and our network of subs. You have to be very careful when you're hiring a contractor based on price. A lot of times, it's manpower that they're cutting back on, and this will cause delays on your timeline and your schedule. So make sure you compare apple to apples when it comes down to pricing. The last thing you want to do is hire a handyman to handle your full rehab. A handyman will not complete your job in the time frame that you need it on. It's all numbers. At the end, it just comes down to how much manpower. Money equals manpower. Progress equals manpower. Manpower equals money. It's that simple, and it's no secret formula. How many heads you got working on the jobs is how much money you got. So don't forget to hit that like button, subscribe, and please comment down below. I want to hear your feedback and what you have to say and what experience. If you have any questions, I'll try to answer everything as quick as possible. Don't just hire help, build a team. At Will Power, we want your money, we want your business. Stay tuned for the next video.